What's up, peoples? It is your boy MM2K back again with another video. All right, but before we get into this one, do me a huge favor, hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, rock those bells for notifications, please, so you know when we're dropping the Stadia dosages. I appreciate all y'all straight up. Y'all know the slogan, say it with me, because I'm not too proud to ask. Let's get into it. All right. So, as y'all know, if you follow me on Twitter, your boy likes to have fun poking the flames a little bit, hitting a hornet's nest. A console warriors out there that swear on their dedicated devices, all right? And ain't nothing wrong with it, You know what I'm saying? If you like it, I love it, okay? That being said, Stadia has surprised me a lot. I'm not even gonna lie to y'all. I slept on this thing. I thought that it was gonna be, you know, maybe in the top three cloud performance things, but really not gonna be a big deal for an overall platform, let alone just cloud gaming. And I'm here to tell y'all that as far as dedicated consoles, until we see the next lineup of next-gen consoles, performance-wise, versatility, when you combine all that together in one package, Stadia is a clear-cut winner. It just needs a more robust lineup. That being said, there's nothing wrong so much with the games that are there. They perform better on Stadia. They perform at a closer to a 60 frames per second. The performance is unbelievable via the internet. And again, that versatility, look good no matter where they at. They look, the games look great 1080 on a web browser. And they look even better on a Chromecast. And if you hardwire that puppy, oh my gosh, oh my, you know what I'm saying? So there's a lot of cross benefits to Stadia, just like, you know, admittedly, there are a lot of cross benefits with dedicated devices. I'm not saying that dedicated devices are trash now, I believe that, and I'm not saying that, I'm just saying Stadia does have its own lane of benefits, all right? Now here's the problem. I'm cool with the console war stuff going back and forth. As you can see, I can sling it with the best of them. But what I don't appreciate and what I don't like, and if you've seen some examples of that this weekend of the around the time of me doing this recording, right before the close of 2019, that there was a lot of people that was spreading a lot of falsehoods about Stadia. And then when I pinned them down, I was like, yo, well, here goes my personal proof. Where's yours? Well, I ain't got none. I don't know what I'm talking about. I just don't like streaming. You know what I'm saying? And see, that's a problem because the unsuspecting consumer, the consumer that says, you know what? I want to play games in greater fidelity and I'm interested in this whole Project xCloud thing, but I ain't got $4.99. I ain't even got the $3.49. You know what I'm saying? It's Christmas time. I got kids. I got bills. You know what I'm saying? But I hear about this Stadia thing and we do have fantastic internet around here. So is this for me? And then if you listen to the cluster blank of people out here in the console war, the device hogs out here that, you know, just keep talking to silly, crazy, silly, goofy, crazy, gumby, dumb, silly, stupid stuff out here that's false about Stadia. If that person takes them for their word, they're like, oh, man, well, this thing don't perform great. You know what I'm saying? There's a whole bunch of latency widespread. It doesn't look good anywhere. And I'm here to tell you that's the farthest thing from the truth. And I have proof where everybody else talking and rambling out here only have other people's emotions. You know what I'm saying? All they want to do is show me tweets from somebody else. Where I put out my Destiny footage and we're about to create some more proof. See that game on the screen right now, Ghost Recon Breakpoint? It's in your boy's library. I love Ghost Recon Breakpoint and I let my brother play it when he came into town not too long ago from this recording. And he's a PC guy and he was impressed. But I haven't got into it yet on Stadia, and I'm about to get into it. And what I'm also going to do is show you how good games could look in Stadia, even on a browser. And it's going to be impressive for the simple fact that y'all seen some of my previous streams. I've tried streaming it from a 2070 PC, and I've had ghosting issues and frames per second issues. So we're going to compare that to what you get on Stadia. Now, no way, shape, or form am I saying that Stadia can ruck with a high-performing PC. I'm just saying it lays in a great space for for its low, low, low entry price of $130. You ain't got to pay $499. You ain't got to pay $50. You get stable, close to 60 frames per second, consistently gaming. You know what I'm saying? If you get a 4K option, if you wanted a 4K 30 option that's stable, you know what I'm saying? And this is early on in the early access mode. So here's what I want y'all to do to continue to provide evidence versus outrage culture bibble babble. Come over and join me right now per the link below on the Hard Knock Digital Culture channel, my other platform, which is right here. You see it right here, where we highlight hardcore gaming, hardcore anime, and hardcore cinema, particularly martial arts. Join me here at hndc.live to see it live. If you don't catch it live, I'll leave a link to the on-demand video, but you're gonna see me doing Ghost Recon Breakpoint streaming, you know what I'm saying, on Stadia. And I think you will be impressed, because I'll be doing it from a web browser. Okay? So again, come and join me, hndc.live, if you're catching this live. If not, I'm gonna leave a link also to the on-demand video. You can come and watch it, but again, be informed. You ain't gotta love the platform, but at least be informed. That way, the unsuspecting gamer that may not be you, you may want all intents and purposes stick with your dedicated device, and that's fine. But look out for your fellow gamer, okay? Look out for them, save them a couple bucks. If this is something that might float their boat, then what harm is it gonna do to let them dilly-dabbing into it? You know what I'm saying? If you're so confident that your dedicated device is so strong and so untouchable, what the hell, what's wrong with letting a few stragglers, quote unquote, know about Stadia and see for what it truly is, okay? Right? Right. So let's be informed. Let's do gamers justice by putting all of the information out there and let them make up their own minds, okay? And that's what we should do as a community. So again, we're gonna do that. Hard Knock Digital Culture at hndc.live, or you can check the on-demand footage below. And with that being said, I appreciate all of y'all. Y'all have a wonderful, wonderful gaming day. Peace.